Hello everyone, welcome to Surah Online. You are watching Movies That Made Me, and in this video I'll be discussing the 1992 cult classic film Poison Ivy, starring Drew Barrymore and Sarah Gilbert. The movie is about a seductive teenager named Ivy, who moves in with her introverted best friend Sylvie. Ivy slowly begins to take over Sylvie's life in the most vindictive way, tearing apart Sylvie's family.
This is the girl that you've envied your whole life, that you always wanted to be in your wildest fantasies, but never, ever, ever dreamed or even thought of becoming someone like that. And for me, being Ivy let me live out those fantasies for 3 months, which was absolutely incredible.
I was lucky enough to have a one-to-one conversation with the writer and director of this movie, Katt Shea. In our interview, we discussed Ivy as a character and how Katt wanted the audience to perceive her.
But Ivy took advantage of
her. She lied. You know, she seduced her friend's father, who was married. Perhaps it's sort of a reflection of what's going on in society, that someone like that can be called misunderstood, like, you know, Trump. And it was intended that you would understand her, deeply feeling that you don't belong and that you have to steal whatever you can to get anything. I mean, Ivy is a cautionary tale. She's insecure, she's lost, she will do anything to get, you know, a sense of home. And that's not who you want to be. Well, I actually wanted her to live and to see her in the end just hitchhike somewhere. New Line, the executive at New Line felt she needed to die for her, for what she had done. Never the intention to have her be idolized. She's bad. Selfish and devious, you know, that the movie gets into a lot of very gray areas, but it's not the idea to idolize this character and what she does. These are not things to aspire to.
Thank you so much for watching Movies That Made Me, and a very special thank you to Katt Shea. Before I end this video, I would like to add a clip of my favourite scene from Poison Ivy. Enjoy!
And how old's your friend?
30.
God damn, you ladies look fine.
Can we change the music?
No. It helps me concentrate.
Let him concentrate, Ivy.
Yeah, because you're next, honey.
No, thank you.
Oh, come on. How about a little penis? It says down the shaft, plan ahead.
Why does the penis have to be so little?
It's one of my hottest sellers. Usually the ladies like it between their breasts.
You sure that's sterile?
You bet.
Come on, Coop. How about a little artsy one? It'd be like we're sisters. Like blood sisters. Yeah, if the infection didn't kill me, my dad would.
Hello, I thought you said you were 30. What's happening?
She's having a little problem leaving home. Come on, what's more important? Death or friendship? Please. Look, I'm just not the type. What's that supposed to mean? Nothing. Oh, but I am? Low class? You rich little bitch with your socially acceptable rebellion. What am I, just another one of your inner-city charity cases? Gee, I'm so sorry. What? That you don't have to teach me to read. Must break your heart. Fuck you, Ivy. You know what? You don't have any class. As a matter of fact, you look like a slut. Coop, wait! I need $40 to pay this guy. I don't have any money. Well, why don't you just suck his dick? Maybe he'll give you a deal. Take American Express.
No.
Goodbye.
I don't think she's 30.
Shut up.
Ivy. One of those bills is 100.
This one?
Yeah, I need it back.
About. I'm the asshole.
Yeah, but you're still my best friend.